thought he was like the inner city poet.
He was this wandering spirit around the city.
Sixto Rodriguez, a Dylan-esque Detroit native who tried his hand at rock history in the 70s.
The mayor hides the crime rate. Councilwoman hesitates. The public gets irate, but forgets the vote date.
When we walked in and heard the songs he was singing and what he was writing, we had to record him. We had to make a deal for him. He's great. He said, this is it.
But it wasn't. Rodriguez's albums flopped in the U.S. Somehow, though, his first album, Cold Fact, made it halfway around the world and became a massive hit.
In South Africa, he was in the pantheon of rock gods.
To us, it was one of the most famous records of all time.
The soundtrack of the anti-apartheid movement, fueling a revolution.
The system's gonna fall soon to an angry young tune.
But at home in Detroit, Rodriguez had no idea. He'd given up his music career. That was four decades ago.
You used to play right across the street there, right?
I played a lot of places in Detroit.
Unaware of his fame abroad and getting no royalties, Rodriguez lived on little, raising his daughters doing demolition work.
I'm not a stranger to hard work.
He made failed bids for mayor, city council, and state rep.
You call yourself a musical political.
Musical political, yeah. I don't see how anyone can't be and is not political.
Then, at 57, he was rediscovered by a South African music journalist and a record store owner who found clues in his lyrics.
We found him, we found him.
They brought Rodriguez to South Africa, and he played to thousands of adoring fans.
Thanks for keeping me alive.
He's on stage, and the crowd is just going wild, and they're singing, and they're crying.
It brings you to tears to see something like that happen to someone.
Yeah.
Well, that was, it was epic.
Do you not think that your story is exceptional beyond belief?
Oh, it's pretty wild, the story, you know. I'm a lucky man to be so fortunate at this late date.
This is a true Cinderella story.
Filmmaker Malik Benjaloo tells it in his documentary, Searching for Sugar Man.
A man who lives his whole life in Detroit, as working as a construction worker, really hard manual labor, without knowing that at the very same time he's more famous than Elvis Presley in another part of the world. So I thought it was the most beautiful story I ever heard in my life.
A beautiful story, but also a mystery. Where were all the royalties?
I don't know. I do think it's an important question, because the reason why Rodriguez didn't know that he was famous for 30 years was that he didn't get royalties.
Do you ever feel gypped?
Oh, well, no, I not in that sense of, hate is too strong an emotion to waste on someone you don't like, you know?
Do you want the fame and the fortune?
A fame is fleeting.
Hey, baby, what's your hurry?
Now 70, Rodriguez may finally get his due.
Thank you, Rodriguez!
Do you ever pinch yourself and ask, is this real?
Is it real? It's certainly a different life. You know, it's certainly not what it was. One.